IoT stands for Internet of Things. Nowadays, there are many physical devices which are producing data enormously. Now, this data is required to be operated from the remote device. Now, there are two requirements of operating this data. One is to check the status of the device. Another is to provide some instruction to the device. Now, similar to the IoT realization, there is also another important area to be investigated nowadays are the IoT design platforms. So there are many ICs which are enabling the IoT realization. We are choosing NodeMCU for this discussion. There are some basic definitions to be discussed first, such as the firmware. It is a low-level computer software which instructs a device how to operate. That means it provides a service to the high-level language. SoC, which stands for System on Chip, it is a small electronic circuit that contains almost all the components of computer, such as the processor, input-output ports, memory units, secondary storage, etc. NodeMCU is an open source IoT platform. It includes the firmware, which runs on the ESP8266 Wi-Fi SoC from Express Chip Systems, and the hardware, which is based on the ESP12 module. This firmware uses Lua scripting language. Now, there are some highlights of NodeMCU. NodeMCU is an open source Lua-based firmware developed for the ESP8266 Wi-Fi chip developed by ExpressIF Systems with TCP/IP protocol. The integrated development environment is the graphic user interface, which is required for the programmer to write a program. So here, there are two platforms to program NodeMCU. One is NodeMCU with Explorer IDE. This NodeMCU is a Lua-based firmware. As we already have discussed that what is firmware? It is a low-level computer program that instructs the device how to operate. So that program is written based on the Lua platform. That is why if a Lua script is written for programming, then it will be executed directly on the NodeMCU interpreter. And there is another platform, which is Arduino IDE. When we write program in Arduino IDE, it is written in C program. It produces a binary firmware, which flashes out all the NodeMCU firmware. So once we write a program in Arduino IDE, the new firmware which replaces the Lua platform. Now, if we write a program in Lua, that will give an error. So therefore, before writing a program, we need to prepare the firmware properly installed in the NodeMCU. Now, this NodeMCU has many features. It is the low-cost open-source IoT platform. It has general purpose input output pins. There are almost 13 pins available on the NodeMCU. There is only one analog to digital converter. That is only A0 pin accepts the analog input from the external source. The SPI pins, that means serial peripheral interface pins, are also available in NodeMCU for interfacing with external devices. There is inter-integrated circuit pins available on NodeMCU for serial interfacing. There is also two types of universal asynchronous receive transmit pins available in NodeMCU, that is UART0 and UART1, which are used to upload the firmware codes to the board. So we cannot use in application when we are uploading the program, that is the firmware or codes. The NodeMCU pinouts descriptions are given. Here, the 9 general purpose input output pins are useful out of the 13 general purpose input output pins. because this GPIO 3, GPIO 1, GPIO 10, and GPIO 9 are used for some other purposes for the interfacing other devices. That is why normally D0 to D8, these 9 GPIOs are extensively used by the programmer as the digital input output pin. The E0 may accept the analog signal from outside, such as the 10K pot variation voltage could be read by A0. It provides 10-bit resolution. That means it can accept the values ranging from 0 to 1, 0 to 3 for ADC input voltage 0 to 3.3 volt. So 3.3 volt is the maximum voltage for the NodeMCU. And also pulse width modulation feature is available in this NodeMCU. From these pins mentioned, the pulse width modulation produces variable voltage depending on the analog signal. That is, the width of the pulse will be varying according to the variable voltage input to NodeMCU. Now, the steps of realization using a NodeMCU, we require the software description of the Arduino IDE. Proper installation is required. The link is given here to download the Arduino software from the website. So if we click on the link, we can download the Arduino software. Thereafter, we have to go to the file and preferences. We have to click the preference, and this link has to be pasted in the additional board manager URL field. Thereafter, you have to go to the tools, board, and board manager. And finally, type NodeMCU in the board manager pop-up window and install the package ESP8266. Finally, you have to go to the tools and then board, and where from the drop-down list, you have to choose this one for the NodeMCU programming. We have to select the port from tools option so that proper port will help us in interfacing. Install the drivers for NodeMCU port interfacing. Without installing this driver, NodeMCU will not be detected by the Arduino IDE. Here is a suitable video for all these steps. Now, as the steps are given, we have to click Control and then click on the first step, that is download the Arduino IDE. And after clicking this, we will get the latest version of the Arduino IDE available here, 1.8.15. And to download this one, according to the platforms, I will choose Windows Win 7 or newer. If I click on this, there will be the download option, and here the download is being started. So after clicking this, we can install this software. Suitable location can be chosen. And it will take few seconds for the installation. Open the Arduino IDE and go to the file preferences and paste this link. So this link has to be copied. So it has been installed successfully. So now we are seeing the Arduino IDE. We can get this one from the start menu. And after opening this IDE platform, I have to go to the file and therefore preferences. So here is the file option. I have to go to the preferences. And in the preferences, you have to click on this additional boards manager and you have to paste the link. And thereafter, you have to click the OK. And here, thereafter, the steps are So go to tools and then board and board manager. So tools, after that board, and you have to go to the board manager. In the board manager, you have to type NodeMCU. It is already installed. If it is not installed, you select the current version. Here it is 3.00. There is no current version exists, so that is why the install is not required here. But in a computer where it has not been installed, the install option will be activated, and you have to click on install, and it will take 2 seconds for the implementation. And therefore, you have to go to again. Again, you have to go to tools. Here, the options you have to verify. All these things will come, and you have to choose the NodeMCU. So here, in the ESP8266 board, which has been installed, the option is already selected because it has already been installed. Otherwise, for a new computer, this option has to be chosen for the NodeMCU programming. And afterwards, you have to go to the port. So first is tools, then port. So you have to go to tools and therefore port. In the port, you have to select a suitable port, which has been chosen here as COM5. And therefore install the drivers of NodeMCU for port and interpreting. So for this, you have to go to the location where the driver files are there. So these files we have to, this application program we have to click. So by clicking on application program, we can install the driver. The driver has been successfully installed. So now our Arduino IDE environment is completely ready.